finally. It's a nice hot one today. Hope you've managed to get outside into your gardens or for a little walk for some exercise. So good evening, Nicole. How are you doing? Yeah, I'm fine, thank you. Wayne Shee's back in the chat room. Just checking messages, that's good. Wayne Shee, good to have you joining us. Yeah, we're just checking in after because I seen you at the end of last week. So over the weekend, I believe Jada Costanaro Cunningham was on giving an interview about all things Lord of the Dance and her life. So I hope you managed to tune in for that and enjoyed that one on Sunday. Apart from that, since I last seen you, I think Matt Smith might have been on here doing some gaming. Oh, and of course, Connor Smith's sports show on Saturday. I tuned in for a lot of that. Hi, Ruben. How are you doing? Yeah, so I tuned in for a lot of that and I really, really enjoyed it. Let me know if some of you guys managed to tune in for it as well. I found it informative. I found Connor a great host. It was fun. So yeah, it was definitely a thumbs up for me. I really did enjoy that. So well done to Connor. But yeah, apart from that, it's just the same old, isn't it? We're still on this lockdown, and I'm not sure if things are getting any better or not. I'm trying to avoid watching the news too much because it can put you on a bit of a downer. Obviously, you need to keep informed, but it can get you a little bit down if you look at it too much. Chris Wang says hello from Taiwan. Hey, Chris. You've seen all that, Nicole. Yeah. So we will wait, as we usually do, for a few more people to join us here in the chat room. Or you know, join us here on the program. And this evening, we're going to go into, we started up the breakout dance last week. It's a girls dance from Lord of the Dance. The choreography has stayed the same right through the Lord of the Dance journey into Lord of the Dance Dangerous Games. Well, altered slightly here and there, but we're going to go over the second, finish off the first part, recap the first part, finish off the first part today, and then start on the second part, because somebody posted me a lovely video the other day of them trying those steps, and I want to pick up from where we left off on those. Hello, is that Melina from Buenos Aires in Argentina? Wow, I don't think we've had anybody from Argentina on the show before. So a big hello to you, Melina. Over on Facebook, Cindy Pittman DiMaggio says, hi, I love LOTD. That's good. That's what we like to hear. We love it too. And hello, nice to see you. Everything fine. Greetings from Mel in Gera in Germany. I love Gera. I don't know why. I love it. Hi, James. How are you? I'm good. Who's that? Oh, it's a tough name to read. Good evening, James. Nice to see you. Well, I can't see you, but nice to have you in the chat room as well, Annie. I hope you're all keeping well. Let me know what you've been up to, because I know it's a difficult time. As I said, over the weekend, at least we're keeping you as entertained as we can here on Lord of the Dance TV. But on YouTube, Sarah Dean says, good evening, James. Can you use your all-time favourite dance move in Lord of the Dance? Thank you. Yes, I'll have to have a think about that as the programme goes on. I'm not too sure what my favourite all-time dance move is, but I will have a think and we can maybe have a look at it. Over on YouTube as well, Emily Atkins says, hi from Edinburgh. I absolutely love Edinburgh. Do you know, I was just thinking actually this morning in the shower that I would like a little weekend to Edinburgh soon, because I haven't been for a long time. Our UK tour goes through there all the time to the Playhouse, the Edinburgh Playhouse. So I've got some amazing memories from there, but I haven't actually been back been there for just a fun weekend. So that is definitely on my hit list maybe this year, if we ever get back to normal this year. On YouTube, Angela B says, we shut our TV off a long time ago, so we just watch the updates on the internet and the news. We spend the rest of the day at homeschool, wonderful music, especially Irish trad and fun stuff. Well, I think that is a great idea, Angela, or a great way to operate, if anything, of the right wording. But yeah, I think that's a good philosophy at the moment, because it's, we all know what's going on, but it's very doom and gloom, isn't it, and upsetting. And I think it can get you even more frightened and panicked by watching or reading too much. So I keep up to date with it, but then excellent what you're doing is keep positive, music, dance, whatever you can do to be active and positive. I'm definitely a believer in that. Good evening, James and all. My husband Nathan asked me to ask how Winston is doing. Also, he's never danced. What do you think he should learn first? Winston is doing so good. He's getting so big, which is great, but sad because they don't stay puppies for long enough, do they? They're so cute as puppies. But he's getting big. But what's very nice is he's getting a lot wiser because they're very smart. Well, all dogs, but English Springer Spaniels are very smart. And we've been teaching him lots. The fact that we're home is good because we've been teaching him lots. So he's getting very obedient and he's been a good boy. And he's just a joy to have in the house. We love him very much. So yeah, he's doing good, thank you. No dance moves yet. And that'll be further down the line, my list of my tick sheet of things to teach him. I've been in a Lord of the Dance mood all day. Oh, I just missed the end of that. But good that you're in a Lord of the Dance mood. Sorry, my chat box went too quick. And Melissa Melsom says, hi, James. Hello, Melissa. YouTube, over on YouTube, Rani says, hello, is that from Amsterdam? Can you show us the last part steps of victory? Yeah, I can show them. Do you know what we'll do? Just the very last step, because the steps before that is a lot of rhythm patterns. Unless, let me know, if you already dance to eye level, I'll do them with you quickly. But if not, it's quite a lot of treble patterns, rhythm patterns. On Facebook, excuse me, I've got hay fever and it's coming at me today. So you could be in line for an odd sneeze. Did Jason send you the video of Liam and Georgina Coleman's wedding flash mob? Because I'm sure I saw you with the tie on your head. Did I have the tie on my head? Liam Coleman's one of my best friends. An old roommate of mine. I can't believe I had the tie on my head, did I really? Oh, is that you that was asking me about that last week? I see what you mean now. Yes. So I did have a tie on my head. On Facebook, Nancy Gonzalez says, hello from Mexico. Hey, Nancy, hope everyone's well in Mexico. And Yvonne Zumba says, hello on Facebook. Hi, Yvonne. On Facebook, Connor McGurk says, I've been waiting all week for you to come on. I miss you. Well, Connor, Connor's an old friend of mine. Now you get to see me here a couple of times a week, Connor. Aren't you lucky? I know you've been missing me all these years. Hope you're keeping well, Connor. Facebook, Lara Charles says, hello, James, from Como in Italy. Now, that is a beautiful place, isn't it? I haven't been to Como, but I've been to some beautiful parts of Italy. Hope you're all keeping okay and well in Italy, or doing a little bit better anyway, Lara. Thank you for joining us. Hope you guys come back to Holland ASAP. So do I. I know I say that I love everywhere, but these are all really beautiful countries. Holland's great country and great people. On Facebook, Florian says, hello, James, how are you? I am good. Facebook, Melissa Melsom says, James, will Lord of the Dance come back to Cardiff sometime soon? I want to come watch it again live. I just never finished watching. You just finished watching the DVD last night. You're amazing and the Lord. If there's a UK tour, well, there's rumours of a UK tour, all right? You heard it here first. I'm not going to give any, well, I can't give anything specific away, but I'm sure Cardiff will be included because we do usually do Cardiff. And what another amazing city is, but Cardiff has really come on so amazingly in the last 10 years. What a place. The stadium, the way it's built right out of the middle of the city there is great. On Facebook, Judith, is that Myra? Mira? Colette says hello. On YouTube, Emily Tolman says, I have hay fever too. It's a nightmare, isn't it? It's always this time of year, spring, when the weather turns, it gets me. On Facebook, Rio PT, hello from Manchester. Well, hello Rio, Manchester in the house. I love it. Terry Cox Thomas says, cheers James. Cheers to you, Terry. And on Facebook, Maritza says, Lord of the Dance, I love you so much. When you return to Brazil, to Sao Paulo, very soon, I hope. There is talk of Brazil as well, so yes, keep an eye out for us. Scott Dives says, whilst we're in lockdown, very much enjoying the Dangerous Games show and virtual reality. Good stuff. I know it's great to have it, isn't it? Yanula says, good evening, James, from Nazareth in Israel. Wowzers. How cool is that? Hello, hope you keep well in Israel. Another place that we've been in, a beautiful place. Tel Aviv, the beach. Bring me to it. I love it. Mia saying, "Hi, how are you?" Yes, I'm all good. I'm all good, thank you. Everyone's asking how I am. I'm always good. I'm always trying to stay positive. Facebook, Heike from Germany. Heike, is that you that I? You're a fantastic fan that I've not seen for a few years. Is that you? I hope it is. I hope you're keeping well. Can't wait to see you all in Belfast again. Yes, we do love Belfast, and Belfast loves us. The fans are amazing. Facebook, Annie Delat says all the best from Antwerp. Oh, hey, I love Antwerp as well. I've seen a different side of Antwerp this time because a good friend of my sister's gave us a walking tour and he showed us parts of it that we hadn't seen before. Beautiful, down around the cathedral, that's the back streets and alleyways and old buildings. It was beautiful. Sarah, you probably missed it. What we're learning today, hoping you include something for absolute beginners. I think I can get my husband to give it a try this evening. I was going to say, Sarah, you're not an absolute beginner, but if your husband's going to give it a try, okay, no problem. What we're going to be doing, Sarah, is finishing off that first part of the breakout dance and learning a little bit of the second part. I don't know if you know any, but what we might do is just something very simple that we can all do together, for any beginners that we have out there. So Julia Joanne says hi, from the Holding Academy Irish Dancers in Shropshire. Well, hello there. Hope you're keeping well. Sorry, I just missed the end of your comment. I think that's right. Holding Academy. I've heard of you. Have I seen you on social media? On Facebook, Kira Hughes asks, aside from Flatley and yourself, who do you consider a very talented Irish dancer? Oh, there's lots and lots. There's so many. In the show, we have so in Lord of the Dance, we have so many. All the leads are fantastic dancers. Matt Smith, Gala Keenies, Old Sam Pap, Declan Durning, Alistair Spencer. The list goes on. Connor Rogers. Lots and lots and lots. Everybody. Girl, I didn't even start on the girls. But there's so much talent. Yes, you know the first most of breakout. Awesome. Hopefully it'll fill in some of the gaps. On Facebook, Helen Snell says hi from Spain. My cousin Ryan was Lord of the Dance tour a few years ago. Ryan, what was his second name? Let us know. But thanks for joining us from Spain. Hi James, what is the first number that excuse me, new dancers learn when they join Lord of the Dance? The first number is, because it's quite a short one, at the end of the first half is our signature Lord of the Dance number to the Lord of the Dance tune. And that's a big, it starts off with two girls, the two lead soloists, have a dance together, builds up, lead solo, end line, everybody finishing off. For that end line, so most of the cast are already out there, we call it a pickup. So a boy and a girl come on from each side just to bulk up the end line. So they only dance those end line steps. So that's called a pickup, and they join for that because it's only actually about 30 seconds of dancing. Even though it's a signature number, it's the end line of the first act. Huge number, but that is usually the first number that people go into. Facebook, Missy France says hello from Richmond. Lovely part of the US. Yeah, Virginia, love it. Hello to you. Sorry to log in late, but it was an important press conference in the Netherlands. No problem, you're here now. Kurt Temple says, would you ever put Thunder and Lightning back in the show? Never say never. Did you like that one? Thunder and Lightning, that was the girls' dance. It was a powerful number. On Facebook, Marisa Lavarini Ribeiro says, São Paulo, Brazil. Hello. A lot of people from São Paulo tonight. Yes, good to have you on joining us. Facebook. Bellina says hi, watching from Portugal. Oh my word, I can't believe again how many countries we have joining us on here. And a couple of people asking how I am. I'm good. Adriana Botta says hi, hope you're safe. Yes, I'm good and safe. Winston and Mary are all good, thank you. They're hopping about back there somewhere. And Nancy Rodriguez says hi from Puerto Rico. We need you here. No problem, I'll go to Puerto Rico. No. Get me on that flight. Whenever this pandemic's over, I'll be there. Don't worry. Sharon Evans says, I interviewed you and Simona when you performed at Carfest North. Oh, yes, I remember that on the haystacks. I couldn't believe you even exercised during your intervals. What's the first thing you do once this is over? Good question. Wow, I don't know. Maybe go out for a meal because I can't take any more of my own cooking. I'll be joking, we're not bad cooks. I think just go and spend time with my parents and family, because you know I don't get to see them a lot as it is, but I don't know, it's difficult, isn't it? I'm very close to all my family, and just probably go and be with family and friends. It's the little things that you take for granted, but to be so cut off from everybody is very strange. But so yeah, definitely just have a get together with everyone. But yeah, nice question. Let me know what you're looking forward to doing as well. Nancy Rodriguez says Puerto Rico wants a show. Yes, well, we could be onto something there. It should. Just, I don't know if you get many shows through there. James, could you please tell me? Oh, I missed it. And go defeat the Bad Lord, Rona, please. It would be awesome. Not only saving Planet Ireland, but saving. I think you're asking Lord of the Dance to defeat coronavirus. I wish we could. Iskra says, oh, sorry, I missed that comment. I'm a bit slow. Facebook, Christopher Beading says, can't believe Zoltan has been part of the family for 15 years. What a man. I know, 15 years. It goes quick, though, I'm telling you. Sean Hogan says, not all superheroes wear capes. Some wear t-shirts with Lord of the Dance printed on them. That's me, Sean. I know, I'll to save the day. You know you want one of these, really. We should get a country counter. I lose count halfway through. I know we really should see what's the most we can get on in one show. On Facebook, Victoria Rook says, "Hello from Portland, Tennessee." That's one place I've never been to, but I wouldn't mind it. Wayne Shee, lovely T-shirt. Thanks, Wayne. Thanks for the support. On YouTube, Denise Armendariz says, "Hello from Chino in California." Have you heard of that, Mary?
No.
No, I've never heard of that. But all of California is beautiful, isn't it? So I'm sure it's a beautiful place. And on Facebook, Sarah Rodriguez says, "Hello from." Oh, who's this? Go ahead.
He's being really naughty.
Apparently, he's been a naughty boy. Say hello, Winston. Say hello. Say hello to the camera. Look that. Say hello. Here's Winston. So he's been a naughty boy, apparently. Mary is not happy. It's crazy hour a little bit earlier tonight. You want to go now? You want to go now?
Come on.
You want to go now? You want to bite my hands? Off you go. Be good. Be good. So that was Winston. As you can see, isn't he getting big? He's getting big and heavy. But he's clever, but he can be wild. Every single person that we meet when I'm out walking, or when we're out walking Winston, every single person, we've been laughing about it, will say, you know, because they're dog owners themselves, not only dog owners say this, but they know about English Springer Spaniels, and every single one of them says, "Oh wow, I hope you've got the energy for a Springer Spaniel. I hope you're ready for the. I hope you have enough hours in the day." And they always make reference to how much energy they have. And we're just like, well, don't we know about it so far? Simi says, sorry, just let me check into this. Hello from Slovakia. Yes, hello, Slovakia. Love Slovakia. I just love everywhere. Tanya van der Vork says, "We had the honor of meeting Michael Flatley on various occasions. Has worked with Damien Noon and Sarah Clark. We still practice Irish dancing, but here in Tenerife, there is nothing." Yeah, Tenerife's a tricky one. I used to go to Tenerife when I was young. My parents had a timeshare there. Beautiful weather, but no Irish dancing. Is that what you're telling me? But Sarah Clark, as you will know, was in the show. She was the lead female dancer, Sersha. Lovely, lovely girl. She was there back when I joined. Over on Facebook, Dennis McCauley says, "What's your funniest moment on stage?" And Owen McCauley says, "Oh, the two brothers back to back. Glasgow is watching." So is that Owen Senior? I don't know what's going on now. That must be Owen Senior, the dad. Family affair going on. Have you got me on at dinner time again, lads? Dennis and Owen McCauley in the house. James, can you tell us what the most difficult things at beginning learn about? Yes, I will do. Back to Dennis's question, funniest moment on stage was probably a time in rehearsals. So, well, technically it wasn't on stage, but there was a funny moment, and Dennis, you'll know this, when we were practicing Hell's Kitchen and Dangerous Games, and we had to bring on extra people onto the stage, and two people were coming on from the same side, and whoever was taking rehearsals, I can't remember, was getting them to fight each other because we didn't have costumes on. So everyone got a bit mixed up and they were fighting each other. Anyway, I won't get into it. It was the funniest thing I've ever seen. On Facebook, Terry Minter says, loving it, James. Teresa, sorry. Hey, Teresa, how you doing? I said, Terrence. Hope you're keeping well, Teresa. And Brenda always seems, Alabama is watching. Wow, Alabama. I've not spent much time there either, I think. Melvin Morton in Spain is watching. A few people on from Spain tonight. And Caitlin Bones is watching from Australia. Wow, so what time is it in Australia? Early morning in Australia, is it, I think? So somebody asked there about the very first scene today, Lord of the Dance, Dangerous Game, and I was pretty taken aback. Somebody was asking about the first things you learn in Irish dance. Sorry, I missed the question. But you learn, remember, it's soft shoe, and then you go into hard shoe. So soft shoe, similar to a ballet, but it's specifically for Irish dance. But it's no tapping in the beginning, just because you've got to train your legs up for the tricky moves that are to come. Tracy Donacci says, hiya from Edinburgh. When you're back, miss you all from the show. Yeah, somebody else from Edinburgh was on. I hope we're back soon. If we get that UK and Scotland and Ireland tour booked in, hopefully we'll be back soon. Natalie Tinder says, hello, I think I missed that comment. Facebook, Bianca says, watching from Saxony, Germany. Surprise, Arizona here. Well, hello there, Arizona. That's, of course, where Mary, my partner, is from Phoenix in Arizona. I wish I was there right now. We were supposed to go there after the World Championships, after Easter, but that's not happening, unfortunately. Facebook, Simi says, I always wondered whether you guys are on a special diet for dancers. Yes, I'll get to that in a minute. And Georgina Coleman says, hey, Jimmy, love Orla, Dara, and Cavan. Well, hello, Georgina, and all the children. How are you doing? I've been seeing you. You've been keeping active during this lockdown. Hope you're doing okay. Hope Daddy's doing okay as well. I spoke to him the other day. So that's Liam Coleman, who somebody asked me about a minute ago. Why was somebody asking me about him? That is his wife, Georgina, and his beautiful children. Good to have you on watching. And so, yeah, getting back to a couple of those questions about diet. And I heard Carl Keeney speaking about this last week when he did his interactive lesson. Everybody's diet is different because that's the same in life, isn't it? Some people, Mary is drinking, she's getting on serious training right now, lifting heavy weights. She's trying to put on some muscle. She's got a very small frame. She's drinking carbohydrate drinks, and I'm trying to cut out carbs. She can eat. She's throwing potatoes. She's juggling potatoes around the place, and I'm not even eating a carb. Well, I am eating carbs at the minute, but you know what I mean. I eat minimal carbs. So everybody's diet is different. That's the same in life because we're all different builds, and it's the same in the show. But what is essential is that you get the right amount of protein. Because you're putting your muscles through such strenuous exercise every night, or strenuous activity, that you need protein to help recover, repair the muscles. So we all definitely take in, it's a high protein diet, or we take extra protein in with protein shakes, etc. But yeah, apart from that, it's just everybody's different. You do need, because we're burning so much energy, a certain amount of carbs. It's only maybe in our off time. Some of us, like I would be, a bigger bit. I put on weight easy, so I wouldn't go too heavy on the carbs if I'm not doing as much exercise. So different things like that. But we have caterers on tour with us. They look after us and have a wide selection of all kinds of food, so it's great. Miss y'all from Brenda. Rainy says, what do you recommend for the hard shoes? Normal size or one size smaller? I go half a size smaller. But it depends on the shoe. Tracy Donacci says, my daughter loves the show now. She thinks you're great. How is Michael? I love to see him live with my daughter. Never see him live when you see me. Yes, Michael's keeping well. Talking to him the other day. And were you on stage the time Zoltan fell off? Was everyone able to keep going without falling down laughing? Was I on stage? I'm not sure. Do you know what? A couple of people have actually fell off. Yes, that was Bandy. That's what I was thinking, because Bandy's fell off during the robot dance. Can you believe that? And he was okay, but that's what I was saying. A couple of people fell off. I didn't know Zoltan had as well. Sharon Evans says, do you still get nervous before a performance? No, I get asked this quite a lot, Sharon. I don't get nervous. But there is an element, whether you call it nerves or not, there's an element of like anticipation, because no matter what, no matter how many times you perform or you've been through doing a live show, you can't get away from the fact that you realise that the other side of that curtain is, for us in Lord of the Dance, the minimum amount of people we play to is about 1,500 people, but on average, 2,000, 3,000, and that can go up to 15,000, 20,000. So you know that the other side of that curtain is a couple of thousand people. So that's what I'm saying. No matter how prepared you are, how many shows that you've done, I've done it for 17 years. I could, well, not do it with my eyes closed, but you know, I'm really well used to it at this stage. But as I said, you know, you've got that feeling of responsibility on your shoulders to perform well and to give the audience a good show and to leave them feeling like, wow, I want to get up there or I want to dance or I want to, you know, feeling good. So yes, it's like anticipation. Is that the right word? Not nerves, but there's definitely a little bit of an anxious feeling. All right, just hoping that it all goes well. Salom Bossard says hi from Switzerland. Provo from, hello, from Provo in Utah, USA. Hello there, I was in Utah a couple of years ago. How'd you do that high jump with a click in the fight between you and the Dark Lord? How'd you do that high jump with a click in the fight? High jump with a click. I'm not sure, I'll think about that in a minute. On Facebook, Sammy says, where are the dancers from? Are they from English-speaking countries? Yes, they're mainly from England, Scotland, Ireland, the US, we've had a couple from Australia, we've had lots from Australia. We have three Hungarians in the show right now. We've had Canadians. We had, when we were in Belarus, this is something that's been new, because Irish dance has spread so globally, we had some Mexicans dance when we were in Mexico recently. We had a guy dance when we were in Belarus, so a Belarusian dance. We've had Russian. So yeah, a big mix, but mainly England, Scotland, Ireland, and over North America. That's the main countries. Teresa Minton asks, are you missing Mick McHugh and him scaring everyone? I miss Mick McHugh, I don't miss him scaring everyone. I wonder how he's getting on in lockdown, in isolation, not being able to scare everyone. That's a bigger question than am I missing him. I can't imagine how he gets by with only the poor people that are on lockdown with him. That's all I say. They must be, have no nerves left. You're probably scaring them left, right, and center. So many people golfing near my parents' house. Crazy. What? You're not supposed to be golfing. You're supposed to be in isolation. But I did take Winston on a walk on a golf course the other day because there was no, well, supposed to be no golfers on it. I didn't see any. And I sent a picture to my dad of me in the pose. I said, I wish we could be out having a game of golf, Dad, but unfortunately not at the moment. I mean, the fight looks like you kick him in the face. Oh, so I think there's some of the high clicks like this. We call them front clicks in Irish dance. We were going over some of that technique in the last class. I'll do one for you now in a minute when I get back up. Right. Okay, sorry, a lot of talking going on there. Just trying to say hello to you all. Sorry, just checking my message. And before we get started, what we're going to do is recap on the breakout steps that we did last week. We'll breeze through that step quite quickly. It's only one step. And then we'll go on to the second part of that and then into the fast part of that breakout dance. It's where the girls throw off their traditional dresses and they're left in sports bra and kind of hot pants, shorts. Quite revealing, to be honest. I'm not sure if how people take that number. I'm sure it raises a few eyebrows, but that is what Lord of the Dance is all about. Trying to be different and entertaining on every single level. So Jennifer Rabe says, or Rabber says, hi from Missouri. A lot of people in from US tonight, so hello to everyone in the US. All right, Macaulay's, I hope you're still with me. I think you're watching over the dinner. Are you ready for a bit of breakout? Get ready for this. Over on Facebook. Hi, a couple of years ago, your team visited Kiev in Ukraine. We wait in the future for you again in my country. Of course we will. We've been back to the Ukraine a couple of times. Yep, Kiev, another beautiful spot. Kelly Collins says, hello from Montreal in Quebec, Canada. Wow. Yes, we've not had many Canadians in. So hello, hope you're all keeping well in Montreal. All right. So, I'm stiff now from sitting down. Right, let me see about this box. Sorry, I didn't take into account that box, did I? Can I move this box, I wonder? Does that work for everybody? Did that move for everybody? My box there. Piet Quinn, Sheila, hi from Belgium. Yeah, the chat box is in the upper left. Good. So you can see my feet a little bit better. Is that all right? All right. Turn my light down a bit. So those steps that we did last week on the strip jig, okay, better shake off. And for the person that was asking about the front click in the duel in the fight sequence, there's one of those clicks coming up, so you can see that now. All right, little quick shake of the legs. We're not going to do too much warming up because we're not going to dance too intently. We're just going to kind of breeze through these steps best we can. So shaking them off, just lift up and stretch your quad there at the back, please. Okay, very good. Change over. Okay, and feet together. And you're just going to go down as far as you can. Remember, try not to hunch over your shoulders. Just keep your back nice and straight. And from here, you're going to stretch down and feel those hamstrings stretching. So straight down. Hold that for about 15 seconds. Okay, and come back up. And just roll your ankles off, rolling them out. Okay, you keep going with that, please. I'm just going to catch up with the comments. I apologize for my nose being blocked up because, as I said earlier on in the program, I've got hay fever and I've run out of allergy tablets because I'm also Winston, our new puppy, obviously brings on the allergies. So I'm popping a couple of allergy tablets a day and I've run out. Now my hay fever's hit. So not a good time to run out. How are your families? Are they keeping good? My family are good, thank you, at the minute. Yeah, thank God they're all well. On Facebook, Capria, it's tough to say, sorry. I respect you very much. Well, thank you very much. Might wait to tilt the camera. Oh, sorry. Might want to tilt the camera down to catch the rest of the floor. I think that's it. I think I'm out of floor space there, guys. I'm just going to go back a little bit. Sorry everyone, I'm just trying to get the best angle for you before we start these steps. How's that? Hope that's okay. Yeah, good evening James, how's it going? Yes, not bad. When are the other people on usually? I think we have the stream, we have a couple of programs. Well, every day Lord of the Dance is something on Lord of the Dance TV. Maybe in the chat box here, Lord of the Dance can give you some more information on that. Mary Coins says hello from California. Oh, I wish I was in California right now. I really do. I'm supposed to be going to San Diego later this year, but we'll have to see what happens. On Facebook, excuse me, says take care from the virus, please. I will. Same as everybody else. Sorry, something in my mouth. Yeah, we're all taking care right now, but thank you for worrying about me. Okay. So, on to that step. So, we'll just kind of go quickly with this. I'm sorry if some of you, it's a bit too quick for you. But it started off with the jump. And there was that front click that somebody was asking about, the click to the bad guy's face. Okay, so it went jump, landing together, and then lifting up the back foot, and it was five rolling trebles. One, two, three, four, five, and back. And then you click through like this, okay? Then from there, after the click, you went down here, traveling back, two, three. So down, treble and toe. And heel, toes, so up on your toes. Down treble, okay? Down treble and one, two, down treble and one, two, three, four, front. Drop and treble and toe, and in your toe, and in your toe. One, two, three, all right? And then we repeat that step, okay? That was all we did of that last week. I now want to go into the next section, all right? Carl is here, sorry you're late. Good man, Carl, you didn't miss too much, just saying hello to everybody. On Facebook, Louise Down says hello from Halifax in Nova Scotia. I nearly didn't know what that was then. Yes, hello to you. That's a place I've never been to. I know this is a difficult question. He was, difficult question, somebody is saying. Michael Flatley was very good or something, and the best Irish dancer. Do I think he's better than he is now? No, I don't think I'm better than now than he was. What people need to remember is Michael Flatley is a genius because of what he created. He created a specific art form. So he took Irish dance in its traditional form and he put it, he turned it on its head. He made it, created something that made it enjoyable. I have to be careful here because traditional Irish dance is still enjoyable, but to make it a show spectacular that around the world there will be a huge demand to see this incredible show. He threw in arm movements, he threw in different intricate rhythm patterns. So that's why it's like his own art form. It is Irish dance, but it's Irish dance with a Michael Flatley twist. That's how I see it. But to him as a dancer, he was a genius to do that, and he was an unbelievable dancer. So no, I'm not going to say I'm better now. You know, there's everybody works to be the best that they can be, and everybody has a slightly different style. But I still don't think I put myself in Michael Flatley's league. He was just a genius on all levels, creatively, dancing, just incredible. Bunny Johnson, Dave Johnson says, take your dress off. on Facebook, Alan Garland says, hello from Brownsville. John O'Shea says, Tony O'Shea from the Daniels School in Ireland. Good man, Tony, good to have you on. And yes, managed to keep up with the first six steps, then you lost it. We'll go back over that a little bit slowly in a second. On Facebook, Louise Down says, my daughter and I got to see Michael dance at a show in New York City. So thrilling. Great, I was in that show as well. Yes, go back there, a couple of the comments. Oh, I can't remember. There was one question I was going to answer. I can't remember. Sorry, guys. But let's get on with that step just a little bit slower. Okay? So, again, I'm going to face away from you. So it went jump. And then we click through. Okay, so it's five treble backs. Then we went down treble and toe and heel up on your toes. Down treble and one, two. Okay, so that was and treble and toe and slide and up. Down treble and one, two. Then we do down treble and one, two, three, four. Front on the balls of your feet, because then you're going to go into a like a shiver. Okay, jump. So far we've got jump. That jump and treble and toe, cut dilly toe, cut dilly toe, and one, two, three, and that's the end. It was Bunny, that's what I was going to talk about. It was Bunny. Wow, what an interview the other day. That got me. Those that remember last week, David Johnson, aka Bunny, was on here saying hello to me. And I said, well, why don't you talk to Jason, who was our social media guy behind the scenes, where he's more than just our social media guy, but he runs all the socials here, and of course Twitch, Lord of the Dance TV. And he did an interview with him a few days ago, and the transcript of that is up on Facebook. I suggest you go on and read it right now. The story of David Johnson. I text David, or I text Bunny after it, said, I feel like going running a marathon after you read his story about how he got into Irish dance and how he joined the show. He only seen Irish dance when he was 17. He started dancing when he was 19, I think, or 20. He was in the British Army. Yes, you heard me right. He was in the British Army. He started to learn how to dance and ended up joining Lord of the Dance and touring the world. And that's how I know him. I was at his wedding. We all danced at his wedding and had great fun. He's now married to Joan with some beautiful children. Unbelievable story. So get onto Facebook and read that. And you will feel like you can do anything after that read. So yes, hope you're keeping well, Bunny and the family. Marissa, do you get bored? Oh, where did you get the board that you're dancing on? That is a portable sprung floor, which come from all the way from the west of Ireland. Cathal Keeney, who's another lead dancer in the show, is involved with the making of these. It's basically plywood with a material on top, which is non-slip, with some rubber on the bottom. It breaks into two pieces, so you can slide it together. Portable sprung floors. Kay Bowen says hi from the West Midlands. Hello, Kay. And Brianna says amazing, thank you so much. Bianca says tease of your dancing, wow, love it, brilliant, thank you, nice dancing, good example for my daughter. Okay, so the next piece going on from that, if anybody wants me to come back and have a look at that section, that's fine. But all that happens then is they dance that section again. Remember, what you can do here, guys, is go on to the Lord of the Dance, Dangerous Games, the Lord of the Dance on YouTube or wherever, if you've got the DVD, and look at this dance, and you will see the rhythm patterns we're doing right here. You will see them there. On Facebook, Melissa Melson, me and my grandfather had a tradition to go watch Michael dance. Sorry, my eyes. Oh, before he passed away 6 years ago, I continued the tradition by watching you live at the London Palladium. It was amazing live. Thank you. Oh, that's a really nice story. And I'm glad you could keep the tradition going. And I'm sure was it your dad or your granddad was watching down as well. But that's a very nice story. On Facebook, Brianna says hello from Michigan. All the USA fans are in tonight, or the USA. USA crowd are on watching us, so I'm catching up with these. Paula McLean says, as a tap dance instructor, you are stretching my knowledge. Thank you. Good. That's good that you're having a go with us, so you'll maybe learn some different rhythm patterns. And hello from California again. All right, so on to the next section. So you just do that again. Then, okay, so the next step, you do a little bounce, okay? So you're going to go bounce up, twist, twist, up, twist, twist. Okay, I'll slow this down. So you go bounce. Now on that bounce, you're going to push. Cut. So bounce, cut. One, two. On that two is another cut. Cut, one, two. So watch that all together. It goes push, up, one, two, up, one, two. So jump, cut, one, two, cut, one, two. All right, tricky stuff. Watch it in full speed. It goes two, three, four. Jump, up, one, two, up, one, two. Then it goes fast double. So down together. All right, so I'll turn away so I'll be on the same foot. So back foot comes down, fast. Okay, so fast, hop, treble, two, three, treble, and toe. So all together. All right, so jump up, down, down, up, down, down. So, two, three. So this left foot. So one, two, three, four. So, treble and toe to finish off that move. Treble, hop, toe. Treble, hop, toe. All right, so all together that piece. Two, three, four. Bounce, cut, twist, twist, cut, twist, twist. Fast and treble, two, three, treble and toe. And again, two, three, four. Bounce, up, bum, bum, up, bum, bum. Let me face you and do it. Two, three, four. Bounce, up, bum, bum, up, bum, bum. Okay, hope you got on all right with it. Let me see. Good, not many comments. That means you must be dancing along with me. I'm very happy with these sessions. I train at home. Let's keep going then. I love it. Okay, nobody comment. That's fine. Let's go. So that section we've gone, let's slow it right down. All right, one more time. You can mirror it now. I'll dance away. So jump, cut, down, down, cut, down, down, fast and shuffle. So three shuffles and toe. Then we do and heel up. All right, so another slide. And heel up. I think the toes stay in front there. And heel up. And heel. One, two, three. Okay? Let me think. Remember, this is a girl's dance. I don't dance this every night myself. I'm just checking this bit out. So we go. Okay, I'm not sure of the way around of the toe, but it doesn't matter. The general is the right timing. So, and heel up. And heel. One, two, three. Okay? So, and heel toes. Then fast treble, diddly and heel, diddly hop heel, watch, diddly hop heel, one, two, three, okay, just let me see them comments. This next bit is the part I don't know. Woo, at last, one where I can keep up with your speed. okay, so, one, two, three. Now, we've got the drums coming up, so we go, I'll show you first. Very difficult, all right, so don't worry if you can't get this, but just have a go. In lessons gone by, do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to move this chat box. I'm sorry, guys. I'm going to move it over here to my mirror, so you can see me a little bit better. Coney Quinnell says, love watching you, James, and good. Thank you, thank you. That's better, you can see me. This section is the drums. In lessons gone by, we've practiced these drums just going. All it is three beats. And you'll see this from Michael Flatley's solos himself. You see this in competitive dancing. Here it is in breakout, okay? This is a girl's number from Lord of the Dance. All it is three beats. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. So back foot down, ball of your foot, back, front ball of your foot, down, and then you roll the weight up on the heel. Back, dum, dum, back, dum, bum, back. Okay? So you can practice that basically when you've got a spare 10 hours. You can do that so you get the right weight balance. Because you don't want it too much on the back foot, you don't want it too much on the front foot, you just want that balance of back foot and front foot, okay? That's all I can tell you. Many hours of practice to get this one. And you're going to do two into, you're going to go three fast, two, okay? So two slow, three fast, two slow into the end rhythm. Okay, so. So that end piece is and treble and toe, heel, and it's actually a toe, hop. Alright? So and treble and toe, heel, hop, down. Watch that. And treble and toe. So and treble, hop, toe. So hop forward after the treble. And treble, forward, toe, heel, pivot, down, down treble and treble. Stay on the left foot. Front treble and treble and back. So it's slow, slow, fast. Okay? That's what that's going to look like. Alright, so slow and slow, fast and slow, back. Alright, are we getting there? Is anyone keeping up? Judith Maya Colette asks, is there any chance of Lord of the Dance touring in South Africa again, especially to Port Elizabeth? I read somewhere that it's where you made your debut and as Lord of the Dance, correct me if I'm wrong. I'd love to see it and see you dance, really putting us through our pace tonight. Could you show real quick again how to go from the heel step into the drums? Think I'm on the wrong foot. Sarah, I think I might be on the wrong foot as well, but I will show you in a second just to confirm. And Carl's getting there. Port Elizabeth is where I performed my first ever Lord of the Dance lead show as Lord of the Dance in 2004, 17 years old, Port Elizabeth. And I've not been back since, so I would love, there is talk of us doing a tour of South Africa again. So, and I'm not just saying that, there's talk of us doing, you know, UK tour. As you know, I mean, there's some time out at the minute with the pandemic, with our 25th anniversary coming up next year. So who knows what we've got in store for you, and then who knows where we'll be touring. That's all I'll say on that, okay? So keep your eyes peeled for tour dates. On Facebook, Sam Taylor says, think you should walk us through Michael's solo. All right, no problem. That we'll be here till 5 in the morning. If you think this is difficult, Michael's solos are a different thing. Could you, real quick. Okay, so from that, before the drums, so it, so this step went, drum up, down, down, up, down, 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 left, right, left. Okay? So, bum, 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 bum. Yeah, I think that's right. I just needed some turns in there. So, and heel, up, then fast, and heel, left, right, left, down with the left. Da-dum, dum, 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 diddly, 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 too slow. Da-da-da, da, toe and toe, down and trouble, fast, trouble, da-dum. All right, maybe that's it fun. Not sure, because then you go on some walks, they call it the walkabout. Facebook, that was about the solo. Now we know why the girls are asking the lads to do a breakout. As you know the steps, James. Are the girls asking us to do a breakout? When was that? I don't know how that one would work. Getting us in dresses to begin with. Okay. One more time with that step, we'll dance it through, and then I just want to have a quick look at the second section. Because after this, all that happens is they go walk, walk, and they throw their backs up, and they throw their a bit of attitude, because the bad girl has come on during this section, and she is basically strutting her stuff to the good girl. She's saying, well, here's me, this is what I'm doing, I'm sexy and I'm attractive, and she's trying to intimidate the good girl. So the good girl is on the stage with her friends doing this breakout number in the more traditional traditional costume, and then she of course they throw their dresses off to more revealing costumes underneath, and the bad girl leaves the stage. So on this section, just the girls go, they walk, walk, up and a walk, while the lead dancer performs a solo section. Still on the wrong foot, left, right, left, but then down on the left again, help. So, jump up, bum, 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 and heel up, and heel left, so back, front, back, back, so it goes, so back, front, back, okay, does that help you? So, and heel, back, back, so back, front, back, and okay, I think that's it. Watch now, it'll be me doing it wrong after spending a few minutes on it. On Facebook, Grace Adam says, lot of love from Brazil. Wow, so many Brazilians in the chat room. And of course, we went to Brazil last March time, I think it was. So it's probably, yeah, it's just over a year ago we were there. And Caitlin Dancer says, Danaher says, how do you remember this? I don't know. Well, I've never danced this dance. This is a girl's number, but you hear the rhythm patterns every night. I guess it sticks in the head. Up on the toes and then dropping down onto the left foot. Yes, so the and diddly and heel, toe, 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 down on the ball of the back foot. Drum and diddly diddly. All right, sorry, that was to Sarah. Should do a charity show when this corona business is over, but the girls do the boys' bits and the boys do the girls' bits. Who's that from? Hey, fantastic idea. I don't know about that. Girls Warlords. Yeah, that'll be interesting to say the least. Which part will I play? I think I do this girl's dance quite nice, don't you? Right, on to that last section. What we're going to do first is recap those two steps. All right, so from the beginning, all right, I'll dance it kind of side on. All right, so 5, 6, 7, and jump. Sure about my jumps there. I think we repeat that step again. Then the girls just go on a walk around, I think, into this step we've just learned. So the jump up, down, down, up, down, down. Ready? 5, 6, 7, and jump up, down, down, up, down, down, fast. And heel up. And 1, 2, 3, get it. And 2. Down. Okay, so that's that step there. Then they go on another walk around. Actually, I think that could be it. Then it's into the 1, 2, they throw the dresses off. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, shake the hair, get nice and loose, into some walks forward. They go 5, 6, 7, push. Okay, so on that 7, we push over. Okay, and that's what we're gonna be doing next. Let's just catch up with the chat room. How many plans, are there any plans on doing Hyde Park again? Wow, I'm not sure, but again, you just never know what Michael Flatley has up his sleeve, so I will never say never to anything. Lena says, you teach Irish dancing at a primary school in Berlin, and the girls love you. Wow, brilliant. And well done for teaching in Berlin. And I'm glad the girls are loving. Is it the lessons? I love, love the dance. Great stuff, either way. On Facebook, Mrs. Mora says, love from Puebla, Mexico. Please teach the basic steps. Jason's note, they're available in the Twitch. Oh, sorry. And that's Jason Rant saying they're available in the Twitch library. Yes, because this is probably nearly our 30th lesson. But, like Jason says, if you're a subscriber, you can go back and watch over the... all those previous lessons, but I will teach you something very simple in just 5 minutes. We'll go over some simple, not tapping routine. We'll just do some nice stuff you can do in your socks, which will get you used to doing the fundamental Irish dance moves. Okay, I'm just going on to this step with the, this is from Breakout. So we've done the 5, 6, 7, okay, the walks too. So 5, 6, 7, sorry, right foot first. So right, left, right, push, and treble. So we're doing single rolling trebles again. All right, so 1, 2, 3, hot toe. So you hop back. 1, 2, 3, hot toe down, hot toe, down treble, hot toe down, right? We got that, so 1, 2, 3, hot toe down, down treble, hot toe down, down treble front. Okay, so that's what we finish with. So down treble down, basically. Down treble down. Alright? Just do that with me. Alright, so that whole section is 1, 2, 3, hot toe down, down treble, hot toe down, down treble down. Because then you're going to push off that front leg. Okay, so you go. And you kind of repeat that first section. I hope that made sense, okay? From Pablo, just checking the comments. All right, so do that one section again. 2, 3, push. Push. Same again. But this time we go tip and treble and stamp, okay? So. So that last section, down, tip, down, treble, and stamp. Okay? Because we push off that stamp again and do the same step again. Okay? Then they go into a moving part.
Then you go back to the beginning. And then they go off again. All right, I'm gonna leave that there. I just gave you a quick blast of a taster for those of you that have been following along with with the breakout dance. Get some water if you got some. I just nearly choked. Ugh. Sometimes if you get to have water. But I hope and thank you to whoever that was the other day that tagged me in that nice video on Instagram of you dancing along this breakout dance. It was very nice. You had it perfect. I just can't remember your name off the top of my head. But yeah, the rest of you, keep practicing that. I hope you can follow it along. Follow it along to a certain extent. Somebody was asking about some simple steps, and I know that Sarah Wakefield's boyfriend or husband was apparently going to join in tonight. So I'm just going to finish off this lesson or wind down the lesson. I'm just going to do some more of the basic moves. Love these steps, very repetitive too, so we can quickly do most of them. Exactly, I did say when we first, back last week or the week before, when we had a look at these steps, it's a long dance, but there's actually only about 3 or 4 steps in it. So in that first section, what was there, 2 steps? In this section, I think there's 2 or 3 steps. Now in this section, you have a lot of, there's kind of the girls do some, I'm not going to get up and show you. Maybe Mary can come in next class and show you this piece. But it's kind of like, I don't know how to describe it, but a bit of shaky going on with the hips and some arm movements in between these steps. So that's how it breaks it up a bit. And then it's just back to that nice, repetitive, but solid sounding rhythm. Have Winston demonstrate the shaky. He probably will. Okay, so for everybody else, any beginners in the house, anybody that hasn't danced before, this section is for you. I'm going to take off these shoes because you don't need your hard shoes for this. This is soft shoes only. There's 2 kinds of shoes in Irish dance. So we all start off in soft shoes, like ballet shoes, similar. Okay. Some people call them Poms. Some people just call them soft shoes, light shoes, because we call these the hard shoes or the heavy shoes. Or tap shoes. Not many Irish dancers call them tap shoes. I have an actual tap on it from tap dance, just for in the show it's lighter for me. But a traditional Irish dance shoe has a thicker tip. All right, same cat, and see a bigger heel than you would have on a tap dance shoe. It would be a smaller heel. So we have this heel because we make lots of clicking noises with our heels. So I'm just getting into my socks. So you can do this in runners or trainers if you like. Or if you do have any soft shoes, get them on. Oh, okay. And what I'm going to teach you is, back, as I said, if you subscribe here to the Lord of the Dance channel, you can go back right to the beginning of our interactive dance lessons and watch all. I tried to take you on a journey through doing soft shoe exercises in Irish dance and dance moves, and then we developed into doing simple rhythm patterns and right through to getting onto some of this stuff. So yeah, definitely if you can subscribe, it would be, and you, if you want to learn how to dance, it'd be worth subscribing and going back over all those lessons. But for now, today I'll give you a little step. We call it a step, as if it's to 8 bars of the music. I'll teach you a step that you can try at home. You can put on, if you go on Apple Music or whatever it is that you're using, Spotify, and just type in Irish Dance Reel or Reel, R-E-E-L. Are your shoes from Antonio Pacelli? They are from FAYS, F-A-Y-S, from Dublin. But Antonio Pacelli, yes, I do Irish dance shoes as well. So yes, type in Reel, R-E-E-L. It wants to be a speed of 113, because sometimes reels can be played very fast, but the speed we want it to be is around 113, like the speed we have it for competitions. And it would be this step as follows. okay? So this is to all the people out, well, everybody, even if you've just been doing your hard shoe dancing, just do this because it's a nice, nice exercise. So with your, you can mirror me. So with your right leg, I'm going to dance it on my left leg, so you can literally mirror me. So with your right leg, you hop on the back foot. Okay, so you go hop, then you point this foot down. So point it down, and you do another hop, but bring the right leg back. So all together, that will be hop, point, hop, back. Okay? First tip here as we're doing this. Your knees in Irish dance always stay together as much as possible. And that's how we end up with these crossed over feet. All right? I'm always saying Irish dance teachers are always like this. The better crossed and turned out, the better. That's in soft shoe dancing and in the hard shoe. When you're doing your taps, you'll notice I was trying to keep like this all the time. It's the same in the light shoes here, in the soft shoes. So we do hop, point the floor, hop, bring it behind. Now we repeat on the other foot, hop, point, hop behind. Okay? Easy. On YouTube, Travel Stories by AK asks, please teach the rocks or drums. We just did some drums actually a couple of minutes ago. I'll teach you some rocks in a second. On Facebook, Caitlin Danaher says, I dance for Maguire O'Shea. Oh, I know the Maguire O'Shea's. What an amazing school down in London. Michael, Kathleen, Ellie, Katie, the whole gang. Lovely, lovely people. Yeah, great friends with them. I'll tell you a good one about Kathleen Maguire. She gave me my first ever Open Championship. She gave me first place when I was about 8 or 9 years old. So my first, you have to go through the grades to get to the top grade, and she gave me my first place in the open grade. Beginner reel is somebody asking. Wayne Shee on Facebook. Sharla Larkham says, love this. Good, good, good. Okay, so we've got the beginning of the dance. So you actually start off by pointing your toe, pointing your right toe on the floor. And that's the move we're actually doing, but you start it with a hop, point, hop behind. Hop, point, hop behind. Now you're gonna do what we call skip 2-3, okay? I always describe this to anybody I'm teaching dance, is as if you're gonna skip down the street, or as children skipping the playground, like hop, skip, hop, skip, hop, skip, okay, hop, skip, hop, skip, hop, skip. All we're gonna do in between that is a skip 2-3. So you're gonna go hop, skip, 2-3. Hop, skip, 2-3. Hop, skip, 2-3. Hop, skip, 2-3. So you're just bringing the feet together for a 2-3 before you do your next skip. Hop, skip, 2-3. I hope you've all got that. Let's move on. So far we've got, let me just check the chat room. Not Logan. Point hop back. Yes, Wayne. Hubby Nathan gave the point hop back a try. Good, good, good. Get him on to the next bit. Hop, point hop back. Lead run. Go, Nathan. All right. So we've got hop, two. Sorry, let's do it together. 2-3-4. Hop, point, hop behind. Hop, point, hop behind. Now we'll skip 2-3s, like I said. So we go hop, skip. 2-3, change, hop, skip, 2-3. Now we're going to bring the right leg forward again, but we're just going to keep it in front and go hop, skip, and skip, and. So like two in front that time. I'm going to do it fast so you can see what I mean, just dancing towards you. So we've got hop, toe, hop behind, hop, toe, hop behind, hop, skip, 2-3, hop, skip, 2-3. Now hop, skip, and skip. And so I kept the right foot in front for those two. Everybody try it with me. Ready? 2-3-4. Hop, toe, hop behind. Hop, toe, hop behind. Hop, skip, 2-3. Hop, left, 2-3. Hop, right, and right. And now we do a jump over. A jump over is like you're going to jump over a wall, leading with one foot. Okay? Lifting the back foot though, so it doesn't kick the wall. And what I mean by that is, it shouldn't be like this. You would have kicked the wall over. So draw your imaginary wall, lift up the leg to go over it, jump over, and bring the other leg straight through. Okay, so it lands in front. Watch that from face on. So lift up your right leg, jump the wall, bring the other leg forward, bring it through, okay? Let me see how we're doing over here. Jump 2-3, that is right wing. Charlotte Larkin says, I remember you at all the Feshes dancing and in Cecilia's age group. Awesome. You're the best Lord of the Dance ever. Wow, thank you. Nice compliment. Charlotte. Alana McFarland says, my daughter, Chadley McFarland, used to go to your dance school in Manchester. Yes, I remember the name. Taught by your sister Louise. Yes. Yeah, I remember the name. Good to have you on, Alana and Chadley, if you're watching. Okay, so I hope you're getting this step. Hope you've only got it there. So one more time up to there, and then it's just a little end piece, and that's your first step in Irish dance done. So 2-3 and hop toe, hop back, hop toe, hop back, hop skip 2-3, hop skip 2-3, right foot and right step over the fence. Okay, so left foot is in front. Now you do another little hop over slide. Okay, so literally that right foot's in front after the jump over. All right, so your left foot's in front. You're going to hop onto your right foot. You go hop, right foot, stretch it out and slide the back foot into it. And then finish the step the same way you started. Hop, point, hop behind. And that's it. Then you repeat, that's 8 bars of music. You repeat exactly the same sequence, but doing everything to mirror what we've just done on the opposite leg. All right, so you note how your left leg is in front as you've just finished. You now start on your left leg with hop, point, hop behind, hop, point, hop behind, and left skip, and right skip, and left, and jump the wall, and slide, and point, hop back. Okay, that's how Irish dancing works. We do everything on the right leg for 8 bars, and then everything on the left leg to make sure we don't get stronger on one foot. How are we doing? Stevie J says, stopped Irish dancing 12 years ago, but dream every single day of starting again. Well, give it a go on here, Stevie. Tell me where you're from. Remember you all the Feshes dancing? Oh yes, I got that one. And Sharon Evans says, I'm having a go. Only a novice tap dancer. Well, that's fine. And this is very, very early stage stuff of Irish dancing. This little sequence here would be, if you've been dancing a while and you've mastered the basic of the soft shoe dancing, of the light shoe dancing, you would have this step then. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed that step, those of you that were trying it. Nathan, I hope you've got it down. Well, once you've got it up to speed, everybody, get on whatever you listen to your music on and type in reel, R-E-E-L, and you want it about, put Irish dance reel maybe. And it should be about speed 113, and then you can try it. It's going to be about this quick. All right, it's going to go and point hop back and point hop back. Skip 1-2-3 and 2-2-3 and right and jump the wall and slide and a point hop back. It's going to be a lot quicker than what we were doing. Let's take it back to kind of medium pace there. All right, and do point hop back, hop point hop back, nice and slow. 2-3-4. Hop, point, hop, back, hop, point, hop, back, hop, skip, 2-3, hop, skip, 2-3, right, and right, and right, and jump the wall, little hop over, hop, slide, hop, toe, hop, behind. The difficult thing in Irish dance, or tap dance, if you tap dancers are out there, is all the little hops in between that connect move to move. You notice how many times I say hop, hop. What I actually mean is, you know, like jump, 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 little jumps. And they connect, they keep you in sync in time with the music and connect all the pieces together. So that's really the most difficult part. You know, you can do the jump the wall, the leap over, or you can do the slide all on their own. But connecting them is difficult, and I get that. Nathan tried, I'll work on it with him. Facebook, Marcello Gomez has met you in Phoenix once after the show along with Michael Flatley himself. It was one of the best shows I've ever seen. Brilliant. I remember that night. Great show, in my opinion. Wow, thank you, Florian. Nice compliment this time of night. And Carolyn Joyce says, seen Lord of the Dance in Belfast. I danced with Mona Roddy
And I know Owen Murphy, of course, was on tour with us. Great Carolyn, yes. Great people, great dance school. They've had a lot of success. Great history, haven't they? So you couldn't be at a better place. I know all the family and the girls as well. Dervla and Kira. So yeah, great school. Okay, one more try with that step and then we'll start winding down. We'll just have a quick stretch. And any final questions, throw them at me and I'll try and get them answered before we sign off here. But I hope we've had fun. We've kind of gone from the difficult current show stuff of Breakout. Sorry, you can't see my head here. Into the right back to the basics of a fairly basic reel for those that are just joining in. I'm just going to say it one more time. Remember, if you are wanting to dance a little bit more seriously, but you feel like you've joined us too late in the day, because this is our 20-something lesson. I think it might be nearly 30th lesson. Subscribe here on Twitch, Lord of the Dance TV, and you can go back and watch all those lessons that we've done in the past. On Facebook, Gary McCabe says, hello from Ireland, Gary McCabe. Hello, Gary, hope you're keeping well. I hope everyone is well in Ireland. Yeah, I'm looking forward to getting over and seeing all my family once this is done over in the west of Ireland. Okay, so yeah, any final questions, throw them at me, guys. Let's just do that step one more time for those that were giving it a try. Ready? Five. Let's put hands on the hips for this. 5, 6, 7, and hop toe, hop behind, hop toe, hop behind, hop, skip, 2, 3, hop, skip, 2, 3, hop, right, and jump the wall, little hop, hop, slide, hop toe, hop back, all right? I was trying to emphasize all those hops for you. And then you repeat that on the left leg, all right? So get that real music on at home and give that a try. Aurora Neary says, will there be a video so we can go back and practice this? All the broadcasts that we do, the streams that we do, are saved here on Lord of the Dance TV. You just have to be a subscriber to go back and watch them and practice. So yes, they are saved. On YouTube, Rainy, I think that's right, Mooja. Says, James, thanks for the lessons. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing your name completely wrong. Did you say you're from Switzerland or somewhere, that sounds like? But no problem. It's my pleasure to help you all out. And more importantly, have a chat with you all and see how you're all doing. Check in with you all. But yeah, I'm glad. I hope you all enjoy it. And thank you to those of you that have said that you do. Rodolfo Jesus Gokwa Cruz. I'm definitely not saying that one right. Hello, James. Awesome lessons. Greetings from Mexico. I'm sorry about my pronunciation, guys. I wish it was better. But again, hello to you in Mexico and all the fans in Mexico watching us tonight. We were just there the end of January, February. And what a beautiful country it is and beautiful people. You treat us very, very well there. We love the fans there. So thank you. Wayne saying, thanks, my King James. Thank you, King Wayne. Hope you're good in Taiwan, mate, and we'll be back there soon, I hope. On YouTube, Stevie J says, you're from Yorkshire. You guys are such an inspiration. Thank you, Stevie. Thanks very much. Can't beat a bit of Yorkshire. Beautiful part of the UK as well. Just right beside me, of course, here in Lancashire. And on Facebook, Aurora says, thank you so much. Facebook, Tara Wargirl Eddie says, hello from Minnesota. Hello. God, there's so many people from the USA in tonight. I don't think we've ever had as many. What time is it in the US? You are behind us, so it's around your lunchtime. Is that right? Morning time, lunchtime. But yes, great to have you all on, and I hope you enjoyed the lesson. So yeah, just start, if you were dancing a lot, let's just start kind of stretching around. YouTube, Escobar 1080 says, hello James, can't wait to see you for a third time in Guadalajara. Yeah, I can't wait as well, I'd love to be back in Guadalajara for a third time. On Facebook, Paula McLean says, I haven't done Irish dance in over 10 years, thank you, I'm going to go through all the classes now. Brilliant, okay, brilliant. I'm not sure if you can forward through or not, because, you know, like this lesson, there's a we do have a good conversation in between, but a lot of the time it's about the steps that we're learning. So you definitely will be able to go back, and it is a progression through the dances. Tara says, yes, lunchtime. Good, good, good. My favorite part of the day. On Facebook, Sean Acosta says, in New York, it's 2:26 p.m. Oh, I wish it was in New York right now as well. On Facebook, Tara Eddy says, my daughter Bridget is having fun with the lessons. Good girl, Bridget. Glad you're having fun. All right, everybody, just bring your leg up for me, this right leg. Just stretch out here for a couple of minutes. And hold that leg back, just pulling it right up. And just holding that stretch for me. And changing over. All right, so you want to keep your shoulders back. Keep your knee in, so it's down here like this. Keep your knee in, shoulders upright, chin up. And then maybe bend the other leg. Pull your foot back and try and act as if you're kicking your foot out of your hand. And you will feel that stretch down your quad muscle. Okay? Just quick groin stretch, so legs apart. We're just going to lean over to one side. Okay, we're just going through these stretches quite quickly, but you can go back and take your time on these. You should stretch really for between 15 and 30 seconds each stretch, okay? But we'll just take you through some of the more important ones. Keep doing that stretch as I'm reading through the comments. Animali says, thanks for keeping me sane. No problem. I'm glad I can help with that. We all need it right now. And Marja Vukadinak, that's a tough one. But she says, hi from Marja in Italy. Hello, I hope you're keeping well in Italy. You've had a terrible time right now. Our thoughts and prayers are with you all. Beautiful country. And Sarah, so grateful that you do these lessons, James. So happy to figure out that bit before the drums and breakout. Now I need to just learn the step where the girls split in half to do it. Maybe next time. Yeah, of course. I'm going to check that bit of the step out for you. I hope I haven't taught it wrong, Sarah, but it's something like that. I'll go and check that out. Paula McLean says, 1:28 in the south of the US. 1:28 in the afternoon. What is that behind us? Yeah, you're about 6 hours behind us. Very good. All right, guys, final few stretches. You've done the groins there. Remember, hamstring stretch, just feet together and just all the way down. You should really feel that now after this lesson. You can slightly bend one knee, bend the other, just to feel it emphasize over on one side a little bit more. Okay, and then rolling your back out. Okay, as much stretching as you can do through the evening, especially if you danced a lot in that lesson. If you only did a little bit, it's not too bad. But if you were dancing quite a lot, just keep going. It's 2:30 a.m. in Taiwan. So a full 12 hours ahead of the U.S. and parts of the U.S. there. What time is it in New York? Is it the same time? So, Wayne, what are you doing still up at this time? That's past your bedtime. And 8:30 p.m. in South Africa. Yes, not much of a difference here from us in the U.K. and South Africa. That's what I like when I travel down to South Africa. We just kind of travel straight down, don't we? So not much of a time difference. And 8:30 in the Netherlands as well, you see. That's what I'm saying. You wouldn't think that all the way over in there, well, it's all the way down in South Africa. Pretty much the same time as us here in Europe. And that's Jason Sorensen there saying, let's give it up for James for live stream, another interactive dance lesson. No problem, everybody. I'm glad I could be here and do it for you. Keep you entertained a little bit at this difficult time. Like I've said in every single lesson, it's just important to keep active, keep doing different things, whether you join us here on Another Dance TV or watching something on YouTube or reading or more importantly, keeping active, because you can do all these things and watch too many videos or read too many books. Keep as active as you can. That's why the interactive dance lessons are great, because we are fairly restricted right now, aren't we? So I'm glad I could have helped a little bit. Thank you all for signing in and letting me know where you're joining us from. I'm not going to name all the countries, but so many nationalities in the chat room tonight across YouTube, Facebook, and right here on Twitch. Remember, you can chat directly here on Twitch, twitch.tv/LordOfTheDance. Chat can go into the chat box here, but Jason at Lord of the Dance does relay the messages across from Facebook and YouTube, so I do see most of them as well. Just last few comments there. Can't wait for the next stream from Ruben. You're working now. I think that's from Wayne. Thank you, James. Night night and stay safe. Thank you, Annie. Debbie Heavey says hi from Boston. Sunny and beautiful here. Stay safe. Sunny and beautiful here in Manchester as well for a change, Debbie. But I hope you're keeping well in Boston. And Tara says thank you. Fun, no problem. You're very welcome. Stephanie May or Mar says hello. It's 2:31 a.m. in Hong Kong. I was in Hong Kong last year. Another place I'd love to get back to. Hope you're keeping well and safe. And Nicole is saying, thank you so much, James and Jason. This is always the highlight of my day. On Facebook, Caitlin Danaher says, thank you. You are welcome. And Sarah Wakefield says, when are you back again? I think we're back on Thursday. Thursday evening. I think we'll go 6 o'clock, if that's all right with Jason. We better check out. It's, of course, because of Jason behind the scenes that all this is possible. He is the man setting me up. I wouldn't be able to set up this technology and simulcasting and... It's a bit out of my league, so let's give it up for Jason for making it all possible. I'm just here doing what I do, which is dance and teach and talk lots in between. So thank you, Jason, and thank you everyone else, as I said, for joining me. Oh, I didn't mean to end. I came back to say goodbye. I couldn't leave like that. My bad. I was like, and goodbye everybody. Bang. Sorry about that. I kicked my table and the laptop went. That was sorry about that. Things were going so well. I had to have a glitch right at the end, didn't I? But sorry about that for those of you that are still here. And I will see you next time. Sorry, Jason. I messed it up at the end. All right. Bye-bye, guys.